we're studying how children with hearing loss and their mothers communicate with one another. And then we're comparing that to how mothers of children with normal hearing communicate with their children.
Good job.
The children visit the lab when they are 14, 18, 22, 27, and 36 months of age, so 5 times. And each time they visit, the research staff sits in a recording room, and we use 4 high-def cameras to remotely video record as mothers and children play with each other, just as they would at home in our playroom. And then after they leave, we have 4 research assistants who spend hours looking at those videos. They transcribe everything about the communication, how the mothers use speech, sign, and gesture, how the children do the same, and they use some really specialized software that allows us to analyze that. Then at the 36-month visit, which is our last one, we also do some standardized language testing. So that allows us to look at what we consider children's language outcomes at the end of the study. So in our data analysis, we can look at what we learned about children in those early videos and those early interactions, and how that relates to their language outcomes at the end of the study.
Point to the ball.
My hope is from this study we're able to identify those aspects of parent communication that we might be able to influence in an intervention. For example, if we learn that the children whose mothers gesture the most have the strongest language outcomes, then we'll be able to design an intervention in which we support parents in using more gesture in their daily routines. Similarly, if we find that the children whose mothers use more sign or who use more different spoken words are the children with the strongest language outcomes, then we'll design an intervention that helps parents to develop those skills. This study will hopefully help children with hearing loss to reach the most optimal language outcomes that are possible for them. So we want them to not be held back by their hearing loss in any way. And to do that, we're going to help, this study will help give families the tools to help ensure that their children are reaching the highest levels of success.